Even though Jason was born and became a monster after he drowned, somebody stuck their dick in Mrs. Voorhees. That was the most horrifying part of that.
Yeah. Is this the ending?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, this was fucking...
That's her in the boat, right?
Can you turn the volume up? Not that you have to hear much.
Oh, nice.
And you didn't see this coming, too. This is how movies ended.
This is a Carrie ending.
Yeah,
was like the first one that really just...
Where hand juts up at it. Well, here you felt safe because you're like cops.
Yeah.
So everything must be okay. And the old lady's dead, so what could possibly happen?
She just is crazy in a boat. The end. Roll the fucking credits. We're done.
But the music is more masturbatory than anything else, right?
Yeah.
You feel like she's going to touch herself.
Yeah.
Oh, she's all happy.
You know, when the chick was making this movie, she's like, I'm going to be huge.
Oh, damn. Yeah.
That is a fucking horrifying. That still made me go like a little like, eh.
When that happened in the movies, when all that place just went bullshit.
I don't understand, though. What happens in the reality of the movie? And why is he a little boy there and a fucking man in the next movie?
I don't know, because they probably figure a little boy walking around killing everybody would be silly. I think she might have been dreaming that. I don't know.
Was she?
I don't remember.
Does it keep going? Does she wake up or no? Yeah. Why a hockey mask?
Why all of a sudden a hockey mask and a hatchet?
Well, they didn't do the hockey mask until, I think,
third one.
Yeah, the second one, he had a sack on his head.
Yeah.
Oh, did he? They probably called silly. Everyone was challenging him to races at camp.
That was a movie they were working out in front of us. Wait a sec, the killer's a woman. No, it's a little boy. No, it's a big man on the back. And I said, no, it's a hockey mask.
They absolutely did. Motherfuckers.
What was the scariest movie for you, Kevin? Of all time.
Let me see. I mean, still, I still think those two little girls from The Shining will unnerve me no matter where I am in life. And still haunts me, like, if I turn any corner.
Yes!
There's always a piece of me going, it's going to be two little creepy British chicks.
Yeah. Why the fuck are they scary? They're not ugly.
Because you weren't
expecting it.
And they were so creepy and calm.
And you realize they were dead and they had been slaughtered, but now here they are inviting a boy to play.
I think it's
They're synchronized speaking. That's always scary. Yeah.
Jack with the worst suggestion ever. Maybe he did it to himself. Mm. His wife's like, you idiot. You shitty book.
I'm going to go see Lloyd and have another drink. Shut up.
Oh, Lloyd, the ghostly bartender.
He's great.
He was in Paths to Glory.
I'd love to sit and get a drink from Lloyd.
Hair of the dog that bit you. Lloyd, hair of the dog that bit you.
Lloyd knew just what to say. He was the guy you talked to. Your money's no good here. That's what you want to hear when you're going to pay for a beverage.
Of course you do.
A bon pen.
Best bartender from here to Timbuktu.
Portland, Maine.
He corrects himself. Then describes how he fucking broke his kid's collarbone by accident.
He does. He somehow finds a way to blame him, too.
5 miserable months on the wagon. But the way he holds that drink and the way he fucking sucks that down, it's like, God damn it, that's what it looks like to take a drink when you're dying for a drink.
Yeah.
That was terrific.
I know. I've seen it a lot in Danny's face. He's seen it a lot in mine. That's what it looks like to really want to drink every day.
Wiener, what was his name?
Lorimar Production, man.
Oh, damn, look at that.
Skip on. Well, once it loads up, skip on down. They don't fucking bury the lead, man.
It's like Columbo music.
There's this house that she winds up living in.
Damn, that's ominous.
And the dude who... There she is, Kim Derby. And the dude who played on My Three Sons, who was Uncle Charlie.
Jim Button.
He's in this. And he's the dude that's the
you better get someone to help you.
Who's just like, hey, don't ever open that thing under the stairs. And she's like, why the fuck not? He's like, you'll see. It's not really the dialogue. But
see, that's Kim Derby.
And she plays a nervous wreck the whole picture. She's always like, I'm hearing things. And they're like, you're crazy.
Oh, jeez, great. Who's that guy?
Look at that Burt Reynolds from Boogie Nights.
See, down they go in the basement. He's the home decorator. And right there in the base of, it's not the stairs, it's the base of the chimney that's sealed up.
Yeah, yeah.
And in the chimney, these little things fucking have been trapped for...
Why don't they just let him out?
50 years because evil, Jimmy, evil.
So move somewhere else.
Well, they don't know yet.
There's little puppet people.
Uncle Charlie won't be honest with her. He just tells her, like, don't ever open it. And she's like, why? He's like, I can't tell you. Don't do it.
Why would you ever buy that house after that?
You don't want a movie about people just moving, Jimmy.
Yes.
They just move. Why don't they just move?
See, you know her, right?
Why would you buy a house where they say, don't ever open that?
But what did she hear?
She was in a fuckload of movies. Yeah.
Did she hear something?
Damn.
She heard this would be a good idea to make this movie. I applaud Kim Darby for making this movie. This movie stuck with me for 33 years, I'd say, at this point.
There's Uncle Charlie.
There's Uncle Charlie, and he's like, don't fucking go in that house.
What are you doing?
Why are you leaving it alone?
Yes, I used to molest my three nephews in there.
Under there, you'll find bones and burned underwear.
Right. By the way, Timothy Hutton's father.
Get out of here. This guy?
Yeah.
No, is that Timothy Hutton? I think it's Timothy Hutton's grandfather.
John Hutton.
I thought his dad looked...
I thought his dad was dead. I think he is dead, by the way, but...
Oh, man, get to the if little creatures. If you look creatures. At him. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. So this has kind of an ominous... We'll go to the next one. Yeah. This has kind of an ominous or creepy fucking vibe to it. Like, some of these movies just had, like, a really scary kind of background feel to them.
It's crazy, dude, how well this movie still holds up. You can't find it. It's not on VHS, not on DVD. Apparently you can watch it here on YouTube.
Sure. Yeah.
Thank God for YouTube.
Anything.
See, and she finds this thing's been walled up. There's bricks and
guys just whistling a happy tune. What is she doing?
She's trying to get under there, man. She wants to know what's. Why is this all bricked up?
I know. Jesus, she's the type that'll go through your BlackBerry, your email. What a fucking nosy bitch.
God damn, Jim.
She's got her head in the chimney.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, now boy, she's.
Here we go.
Let the monsters run out now. What the fuck?
You got to build it up.
Oh.
Zip ahead again.
Okay, Sally.
Please.
Uh-oh. Problem.
Keep going.
That's why I'm not a good movie maker, because I would just have the monsters run out 8 minutes into the movie and leave.
Ooh. Yeah, Jim Hutton is Timothy Hutton's dad.
And he looks just like him. Oh, it's him. That young guy. I thought you were talking about Uncle Charlie. Yeah, this guy. This
he
is
looks
his
just
dad.
Like
yeah.
Timothy
he really, he walks like him, too. Holy yeah, shit.
Totally.
That's bizarre.
That's his dad.
You just married me because I'm the perfect hostess.
No.
You're a wreck.
No. Exactly.
Could you imagine what family dinners were like? It's like, I was in Ordinary People.
Yeah.
He's like, I was in Don't Be Afraid
of the Dark.
A Laura Marr production. Okay, so once they zoom in on Doris, that's where you start hearing those creepy voices and shit. Yeah, oh, it's very much that.
Very creepy.
Oh, yeah. See, look. See the lights and the little feet and shit. Now they're going to push
the
key out.
Pushed out of the keyhole.
And now they can grab the key with their little hands.
Damn, yo.
Oh, they put it on the thing. Slide it back under. Oh, shit.
Oh, that's right. They were able to get the key that way.
So they can open it from the other
side.
That
old gag.
And enter our world.
Shit.
They must be pretty tall. They can get the doorknob.
There are a few of them. I think they stand on each other's
Sides. Each other's shoulders. Little
zip down again.
Creepy shoulders.
Okay, there you go. Whenever you see shots like this, you're about to see the creatures. Like, they built large versions of miniature corners in the kitchen, and that's when they shuffle out.
Well, it could be, but I kind of...
You know what's great? And you could tell, and I knew it, because I just went here. The director of this did everything. Star Trek, Night Gallery, all kinds of these old TV shows. Next Step Beyond, Police Woman. He directed 5 Police Woman episodes.
Hey, Danny, go back a little bit, I think, because you could hear, obviously, under the bed, she heard it. Let's hear what they said.
Wonder Woman.
Oh, man, that's
oh they knocked an ashtray over.
Damn, yo.
She's stepping through glass with her bare feet.
I'm looking for a Columbo. I know he's had to have directed a few Columbos.
Go to that next clip.
It looks just like
Timothy Hutton's father's drying his face, wondering what it's like to win an Oscar your first time out and then do nothing of value for 20 years.
So you never get up. Why is she investigating?
Now you hear him whispering?
Still.